So today in the morning we were studying about common carotid. Then we studied about the external carotid artery and its branches. So there were 8 branches, remember? There were 3 branches arising anteriorly. And they were inferior or superior. Batao. Name the anterior branches of external carotid artery. The anterior branches of external carotid artery are superior thyroidal artery arising below the greater cornua of the hyoid. At the level of the greater cornua, it was lingual. Above the level of the greater cornua, it was facial artery. So there were 3 anterior. Then there were medial arteries. Medial was only 1, and that was ascending pharyngeal artery. Then there were 2 posterior arteries. Posterior arteries were occipital and posterioricular. Occipital artery was arising at the level of facial artery. Posterioricular were arising at the upper border of posterior valley of digastric. Terminal branches were maxillary and superficial temporal. Okay. So out of these, we had done with the anterior branches, we had done with the superior thyroidal artery. Then we had done with the lingual artery. We completed lingual, then facial artery was also done. Okay. Facial artery was also done. Which is the largest branch of facial artery? What is the largest branch of facial artery? Submental. Good. The first branch of facial artery. First branch of facial artery. Ascending palatine. Good. Which branch of facial artery anastomosis with the branches of internal carotid artery? Which branch of facial artery anastomosis with the branches of internal carotid artery? Yes, this is the this is the facial artery having an oblique course running upwards by the side of the cheeks, reaching to the lateral side of the nose. There it's called lateral nasal. Then it reaches to the medial canthus, and it's this angular artery which anastomosis with the branches from the ophthalmic artery. And these are supratrochleus, supraorbital, dorsal nasal arteries. All these are branches from ophthalmic artery, which are branches from ophthalmic artery is a branch of internal carotid. So there at the medial canthus of the eye, you find is anastomosis between internal carotid and external carotid. Facial artery was done. Then facial artery, we had done some mental branch of facial artery is also done. Ascending palatine branch of ye bhi yaad ho gaya tumhe. Okay. Course of facial artery you have seen. Branches supplying the tonsil also has been done. Now we will start with occipital artery. Now the posterior branches. So one of the posterior branch is occipital artery. I told you that this you are seeing here, this is the occipital artery. Occipital artery, you are seeing it arises posteriorly from the external carotid artery at the level or opposite to the origin of facial artery. Clear? Then this artery, occipital artery, runs along the posterior border of or inferior border of posterior belly of digastric. Okay? In its course, you can see this occipital artery gives out two branches to the upper one third of sternocleidomastoid muscle. OOSS, याद आ गया, blood supply of sternocleidomastoid. So upper one third is supplied by two branches from occipital artery. So this first branch, I mean, you know, there are two branches. The upper branch, upper muscular branch to sternocleidomastoid, that runs along with accessory nerve. Remember, in the posterior triangle, there was accessory nerve. So this artery runs along the accessory nerve to supply the sternocleidomastoid upper branch. Then the lower branch, the lower muscular branch, that is, you can say, it arises at the origin of occipital artery. So as this occipital artery arises opposite to facial artery, it soon gives its first branch to sternocleidomastoid. Then it ascends and again gives another branch to sternocleidomastoid, the upper one-third portion. And this upper twig that follows the course of spinal accessory nerve. Then when it reaches, you know, it follows this course and reaches the mastoid process. At the mastoid process, it goes along the mastoid process along the posterior belly of digastric. There it also gives a descending branch, and this occipital artery then pierces semispinalis and reaches the post suboccipital triangle on the back of the head. Here you seeing this dotted line is the carotid triangle. And within the carotid triangle, there are three anterior branches that take origin. We have studied about them. Okay, superior thyroidal, lingual and facial. Then the posterior branch, this occipital artery, also arises within the carotid triangle as well as the ascending pharyngeal. The posterior auricular artery arises from the external carotid posteriorly, but at the upper border of the carotid triangle. Now look, this occipital artery, this you see, occipital artery, it is like, you know, it is running upwards, backwards, and posteriorly, you know, behind the, along the posterior inferior border of the digastric posterior belly to reach the mastoid process. Here you seeing is a horizontal, or you can say transverse section. So when you see transverse section, this is the cut portion of external carotid artery. What they have tried to show that at the same, if you take a transverse section at the same plane where this facial artery is given out anteriorly, in the same plane you will find there is origin of occipital artery. So it's easy to know now if they would like, you know, in a spotting or in a MCQ or an image based question, if they ask like, if this is facial artery, which artery is this? So you should know that at the same plane, facial artery and occipital artery are given out. Now you'll see this is internal carotid. So it is run superficial to that, and it runs along the post inferior border of the, you know, posterior belly of the digastric, reaches this mastoid process. And on the mastoid process, there are four muscles actually inserted. These are, you know, sternocleidomastoid, splenius capitis, longissimus capitis, as well as there is origin of digastric. So this muscle is deeper to that, and it grooves the mastoid process to reach the back of the skull. In this diagram, you've been taught about this posterior triangle on the neck, on the side of the neck. Then there, this muscle is sternocleidomastoid, and deeper to this sternocleidomastoid will be the posterior belly of digastric. So there you find this artery emerging out. This is occipital artery. It reaches to the mastoid process, and it further continues above. then it pierces semi-spinalis, splenius capitis. Actually, it pierces splenius capitis. You can see it has erupted up here from this muscle. So it pierces splenius capitis, and then it reaches the suboccipital triangle, which is at the back of the head. So there you find this is the back portion of the nape of the neck. You have seen that this is splenius capitis. This muscle was forming the upper portion of the floor of posterior triangle. This this artery, occipital artery, is perforating splenius capitis to enter into this area. This area on the back is called the suboccipital triangle, and the occipital nerve, the great occipital nerve, that pierces semispinalis capitis. Both nerve and artery, occipital artery and greater occipital nerve, they ascend further together into this suboccipital triangle. This you are seeing is a suboccipital triangle. The lateral boundary is formed by the superior oblique muscle, and the inferior boundary you can say is formed by this inferior obliquus capitis, and the medial boundary is formed by two muscles, one from atlas, other from the axis spine. And this is rectus capitis posterior minor, this is rectus capitis posterior major. So medially you have two muscles forming the medial boundary. Superolateral is by the superior obliquus capitis, and inferior laterally it is by inferior obliquus capitis. So this triangle is called the suboccipital triangle, and within this you find this artery and this nerve. The greater occipital nerve reaches by crossing this inferior obliquus capitis, and this grooves the mastoid occipital artery. So both of them are running superficially in this triangle to reach the back of the head. Okay, so obviously this artery is going to supply the muscles here in the suboccipital region. Now once again the branches, let's summarize the branches. This is facial artery given off anteriorly, and at the same plane posteriorly the artery given out is occipital artery. And remember that hypoglossal nerve in its course, it actually crosses two arteries. It crosses occipital artery at its origin, and it also crosses the cervical loop of the lingual artery, both of them. Then occipital artery runs, you can see, is along the lower border of posterior belly of the digastric. Then it supplies this muscle and pierces, and it runs deep to that, and it reaches the undersurface of the mastoid process. So in its course, you've seen just at the origin, it has given out its first muscular branch to sternocleidomastoid. The second muscular branch, it runs along the spinal accessory nerve to supply the upper one third of the sternocleidomastoid. Then the third branch, you can see, is given off in the mastoid region, behind to the mastoid. And this branch is very, very important, and this is called the stylomastoid branch. But let me tell you, this is a occasional branch. Actually, I told you, behind this or medial to the mastoid process, there's a foramen. In between the mastoid and styloid process, there's a foramen called stylomastoid foramen, and through that foramen, it was facial nerve that emerges out from the cranium. And facial nerve, remember, I had taught you when I was teaching you about the muscles, the nerve supply of the muscles of face. And there I taught you about the lower and upper motor facial nerve palsy. So infranuclear palsy is Bell's palsy. And there I told you one of the reasons of infranuclear facial nerve palsy was ischemia of stylomastoid branch of posterior auricular artery. So remember that the artery which supplies facial nerve within the stylomastoid foramen is the stylomastoid branch of posterior auricular artery. That means primarily this artery which goes within the stylomastoid foramen is from posterior auricular artery. But here from occipital artery, this is an occasional branch. Then behind the ear, when it reaches behind the ear, it gives a posterior auricular branch. This posterior auricular branch supplies the pinna from behind. That means the temporal surface, or you can say the medial surface of the pinna, is, you know, the blood supply is by the auricular branch of occipital artery. Then it gives its mastoid branch. Mastoid branch, there's a mastoid foramen. It reaches through that, and it also supplies the muscles in this region. Then here you see is a meningeal branch. Meningeal branch of occipital artery. This meningeal branch of occipital artery also enters into the skull and supplies the meninges in the infratentorial portion of the cranium. Then it has a descending branch. Okay, because down below in the skull you'll have foramen magnum. Okay, so from that it is, you see, it's emerging out and it's supplying the vertebral artery. Okay, so the descending branch supplies the vertebral artery. It also supplies deep cervical fascia, as well as from transfer, actually it anastomoses down below. When it descends down, it anastomoses, a vertical anastomosis there between the deep cervical artery and the transfer cervical artery. Theek? Hope you remember about these two arteries. So these two arteries, when they have a vertical anastomosis and it descends primarily to supply the vertebral, and it anastomosis with the vertebral artery. Yani ki vertical anastomosis with the back of neck. Then this artery, you can see this is the outline of the skull. So it ascends up and reaches to the superior nuchal line. Theek hai? I mean, yahan pe jo muscle hai, that is splenius capitis. So it perforates splenius capitis, you can see, and reaches the suboccipital triangle. This is layer by layer dissection on the back of the head or back of the neck. This muscle, there are four layers on the muscles of the back. This is the most superficial muscle called the trapezius. And these are the dorsal primary rami from the cervical nerves. And this one is the greater occipital nerve. And this is the occipital artery. So after removing dissecting trapezius, now what you see is levator scapulae to side me with the floor of the posterior triangle and splenius capitis. This artery, occipital artery, emerges by piercing splenius capitis. Then above to that is semispinal scapitis. Semispinal scapitis se kaun si nerve aati hai? Greater auricular. So both of them, they ascend up back and supply the scalp as well. Okay, after removing this splenius capitis, you will find it looks like this. So ultimately, both these arteries and nerves, they reach up and supply the skin on the back of head, the scalp. Next artery, the next artery is posterior auricular artery. There were two branches given out posteriorly. One was occipital. This was occipital. Okay. And the other branch given out posteriorly is posterior auricular artery. The posterior auricular artery is given out from external carotid at posteriorly at the upper border of posterior belly of digastric. This muscle is posterior belly of digastric. Second brinchial artery develop hoti hai, facial nerve supply hoti hai iski. So this is posterior auricular branch. The posterior auricular branch continues its course along the posterior belly of the digastric, right? Then when it reaches, behind the external auditory meatus, now you'll see it gives a stylomastoid branch. This is what I was saying in the facial nerve palsy. We talk about the ischemia of stylomastoid branch, right? Which leads to lower motor neuron paralysis of facial nerve. Now, there's a foramen from where facial nerve will emerge out. So primarily, as I said, that stylomastoid branch is a branch of posterior auricular artery. But in the previous artery, you have seen that sometimes this stylomastoid branch may also arise from occipital artery. Okay? So, then stylomastoid branch, you know, it supplies, ab ye andar chali jati hai, right? Cranium mein andar chali jati hai, stylomastoid foramen se, and it reaches there and supplies the middle ear, it supplies the mastoid antrum, the cavity and the air spaces, the ear cells, mastoid antrum and the middle ear, and also the semicircular canals of the internal ear, and it also supplies the facial nerve. Remember, these are all the structures which are supplied by stylomastoid branch of posterior auricular artery. Okay, there you see this artery, this is occipital artery at the level of facial artery from external carotid given out posteriorly. Now this is the outline of carotid triangle. So posterior auricular artery is given out at the upper margin or upper border of carotid triangle. ठीक है? यानी इसके नीचे जितनी भी vessels थीं, they were all content of carotid triangle. बस posterior auricular runs along the upper margin or upper border of the carotid triangle. Okay. Now posterior auricular artery, you know, there's this parotid gland here, and this is retromandibular vein, and this is posterior auricular vein, and posterior division of retromandibular together joined to form external jugular. Okay, and deep common facial and deep facial along with the anterior division of retromandibular together joined to form the common facial, and common facial drains into the internal jugular vein. By the way, now you see that within this facial, I mean the parotid gland, facial nerve was given out its five terminal branches, which were emerging out from the anterior border of the parotid. However, there was one branch of facial nerve which was given out posteriorly behind the ear auricle. And this was the posterior auricular nerve. Hope you remember the mnemonic I told you for the branches of facial nerve, extracranial branches of facial nerve. The mnemonic was. किसी को याद आ रहा है? Wow. पीछे तुम ज्यादा बात मत करो यार, याद रहेगा? Okay. So posterior auricular nerve यहाँ पे जो है, it supplies the muscles here. Let me ask you now, posterior auricular nerve will supply what muscles there? Posterior auricular nerve will supply the posterior auricularis muscle. There are three muscles to move the pinna. There is anterior, superior and posterior auricular muscles. The posterior auricular muscles and occipital bellies of occipitofrontalis, that will be supplied by posterior auricular nerve. Anyways, now at the same, in the same, you know, the as the same name, posterior auricular nerve ho gayi, facial nerve ki branch, posterior auricular artery, it's a branch from external carotid, and posterior auricular vein. So all of them, artery, vein and nerve, they are all having a similar course running behind the external auditory meatus, behind the pinna. Okay. Then posterior auricular artery, here it runs deep to the parotid gland, but it is superficial to the steloid process. Like, you know, if you remove the gland here, deep below you will find is a styloid process. So the artery runs in between, like it's deeper to parotid gland, but it's superficial to the steloid process, right? In between the two, it runs and ascends up on the behind the ear. Now, ये बहुत वाइवा का हिट क्वेश्चन होता है. पूछ लेते हैं ईयर पिन्ना की ब्लड सप्लाई बताओ. नर्व सप्लाई तो मैं बता ही चुका हूं एक बार पहले, हमें नर्व सप्लाई को रिवाइज कर दे. व्हाट इज द नर्व सप्लाई ऑफ पिन्ना? देखो, पिन्ना में दिस यू नो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल दिस इज राइट और लेफ्ट पिन्ना, पहले तो यही कंफर्म कर दो ओरिएंटेशन डायग्राम का। दिस इज लेफ्ट पिन्ना, ओके, सो दिस इज लेफ्ट पिन्ना, सो दिस इज द आउटर सरफेस। आउटर सरफेस ऑफ पिन्ना, अपर टू थर्ड ऑफ द आउटर सरफेस ऑफ पिन्ना, द नर्व सप्लाई इज सेंसरी सप्लाई, द सेंसरी नर्व सप्लाई ऑफ द अपर टू थर्ड ऑफ द आउटर सरफेस ऑफ पिन्ना, ये कौन सी नर्व सप्लाई होगी इस एरिया की? ऑरिकुलो टेम्पोरल, गुड, ऑरिकुलो टेम्पोरल प्रिया रानी, सो दिस इज ऑरिकुलर रीजन ऑफ ऑरिकुलो टेम्पोरल नर्व, सेंसरी सप्लाई है ये, ठीक है। देन व्हाट विल बी द नर्व सप्लाई, बिकॉज सेंसरी इज बाय ट्राइजिमाइनल, ट्राइजिमाइनल मैंडिबुलर डिवीजन V3 डिवीजन का पार्ट होती है ऑरिकुलो टेम्पोरल। देन व्हाट विल बी द सप्लाई ऑफ ईयर लोब्यूल लेटरली इन द लोअर वन थर्ड आउटर सरफेस दिस एरिया, द नर्व सप्लाई, सेंसरी नर्व सप्लाई इज बाय, यस, ग्रेट ऑरिकुलर नर्व, सनी, दिस इज ग्रेट बाय ग्रेट, एंड देन ग्रेट ऑरिकुलर नर्व इज अ ब्रांच ऑफ सर्वाइकल प्लेक्सस, ठीक है, C2 C3 वेंट्रल प्राइमरी रैमस सर्वाइकल प्लेक्सस से आ रही थी। तो नाउ दिस ग्रेट ऑरिकुलर नर्व सप्लाइज बोथ द सरफेस एंटीरियर एंड पोस्टीरियर सरफेस ऑफ ईयर लोब्यूल दैट इज लोअर वन थर्ड ऑफ द पिन्ना, एंटीरियर एंड पोस्टीरियर ऑल्सो, इट इज बाय ग्रेट ऑरिकुलर नर्व। देन व्हाट इज द नर्व सप्लाई ऑफ द अपर टू थर्ड ऑफ द पिन्ना ऑन इट्स, यू कैन से पोस्टीरियर सरफेस और मीडियल सरफेस और टेम्पोरल सरफेस, व्हाट इज द नर्व सप्लाई ऑफ पिन्ना इन इट्स मीडियल सरफेस, अपर टू, यस, लेसर ऑक्सीपिटल, जानवी त्रिपाठी, सो दिस इज लेसर ऑक्स बाय लेसर ऑक्सीपिटल नर्व। नाउ लेसर ऑक्सीपिटल नर्व इज अ ब्रांच ऑफ, अगेन, नाउ दिस ऑल्सो इज अ वेंट्रल डिविजन ऑफ सर्वाइकल प्लेक्सस एंड फ्रॉम C2 डिविजन, ठीक है। तो ईयर्स की नर्व सप्लाई, सेंसरी नर्व सप्लाई सप्लाई पता तुम्हें चल गई कि मैं यू नो ट्राइजिमाइनल सप्लाई ओनली आउटर अपर टू थर्ड, बाकी सर्वाइकल प्लेक्सस से सप्लाई है। नाउ द ब्लड सप्लाई ऑफ पिना, एंड यू सी हियर दिस इज एक्सटर्नल कैरोटिड, राइट, एंड दिस इज द मैक्सिलरी आर्टरी, ठीक, एंड दिस इज पोस्टियर ऑरिकुलर आर्टरी, दिस विल बी ऑक्सीपिटल आर्टरी, ठीक। तो इसका मतलब ये हो गई सुपरफिशियल टेम्पोरल, राइट, यू नो द कोर्स, एक्सटर्नल कैरोटिड की पोस्टियर ब्रांचेस क्या है, ऑक्सीपिटल है, पोस्टियर ऑरिकुलर है, उसके बाद ही टर्मिनली डिवाइड इनटू मैक्सिलरी एंड सुपरफिशियल टेम्पोरल। सो ईयर की जो ब्लड सप्लाई है आगे की तरफ वो किसके किससे हो जाएगी, ऑक्सीपिटल भी कर रही है, ऑरिकुलर ब्रांच दे रही थी, पोस्टियर ऑरिकुलर भी देगी, बट पोस्टियर ऑरिकुलर यू कैन से इज इन डॉटेड लाइंस, तो पोस्टियर बिकॉज इट मूव बिहाइंड द पिना, सो पोस्टीरियर सरफेस ऑफ द पिना इज सप्लाइड, यू नो ब्लड इज सप्लाइड बाय पोस्टियर ऑरिकुलर एंड ऑक्सीपिटल, एंड एंटीरियर सरफेस इज सप्लाइड बाय द ऑरिकुलर ब्रांच ऑफ सुपरफिशियल टेम्पोरल आर्टरी, ओके। Now you had the branches in the course, you know that posterior auricular artery is a posterior division, posterior branch of external carotid given out at the upper border of the digastric. It follows the same course when reaches the mastoid process. It grooves the mastoid process and it gives branches. These are the branches. The artery occasionally gives a stylomastoid branch. When present, it replaces the branch from occipital artery. ये इन्होंने ये लिख दिया है, but mostly it is from पोस्टियर ऑरिकुलर आर्टरी, एंड दिस इज द स्टाइलोमैस्टॉइड ब्रांच फ्रॉम द पोस्टियर ऑरिकुलर आर्टरी, देन इट सप्लाइज द ऑरिकुलर ब्रांचेस सप्लाई बोथ क्रेनियल एंड लेटरल एस्पेक्ट ऑफ द ऑरिकुल, ठीक है, अपर टू थर्ड, यू कैन से अपर टू थर्ड ऑफ द पिन्ना इज सप्लाइड बाय पोस्ट आई मीन ऑरिकुलर ब्रांच फ्रॉम द पोस्टियर ऑरिकुलर आर्टरी, मेनली द पोस्टियर सर्फेस, देन ऑक्सीपिटल ब्रांचेस, देखो ऑक्सीपिटल आर्टरी अलग होती है, ऑक्सीपिटल ब्रांचेस फ्रॉम द पोस्टियर ऑरिकुलर दे सप्लाई द स्कैल्प अबव एंड बिहाइंड द ईयर, एंड अल्टीमेटली इट विल एनास्टमोस ऑन द बैक ऑफ हेड विद द ब्रांचेस ऑफ ऑक्सीपिटल आर्टरी, ठीक। Now on the scalp, when you see this has been taught to you, the nerve supply, याद रखना, nerve supply, sensory and motor nerve supply and blood supply of scalp itself, it's a question of 5 marks. So make sure you learn this diagram very well. This all has been taught to you. So only thing I want to convey is there is another anastomosis between internal and external carotid arteries at the level of scalp also, right? Because you know superficial temporal and posterior auricular arteries and occipital artery, these are all branches from external carotid. However, supraorbital, supratrochlear artery, they are branches from ophthalmic artery, which is a branch from internal carotid, and these are arising from within the cranium. So there is an anastomosis between internal and external carotid arteries at the scalp, or you can say in the temple region, as well as on the medial canthus of the eye, okay, at the root of the nose. Two sides bata diya tumko. Now the medial branch, the only branch which arises medially is ascending pharyngeal artery. Iske baare mein bataya tha maine ki ascending pharyngeal artery is given out from external carotid artery at its beginning. As soon as this external carotid artery arises from the common carotid artery, it gives out its branch, ascending pharyngeal artery. ठीक, क्योंकि इसके बारे में ये कहा जाता है, it is given out at the origin of external carotid. That means it is the first branch of ascending pharyngeal artery. It is the only branch which arises medially from external carotid. Now when it ascends up, it comes to lie in deep or posterior relation to external carotid. ठीक है, जैसे घूम के इसके पीछे चली जाती है external carotid. ठीक. Now, ascending pharyngeal artery का course क्या होता है? Ascending pharyngeal artery है, ठीक? So this will ascend, it will lie in deep relation. Remember, it will lie in deep relation to the external carotid. When it ascend up, then it when it ascends upwards, it ascends between lateral pharyngeal wall, right, and tonsil. तो जब ये ऊपर जाएगी तो एक तरफ टॉन्सिल और असेंडिंग फेरिंजियल लेटरल फेरिंजियल वॉल के बीच में असेंड करेगी, ठीक, इन द नेक रीजन. एंड व्हेन इट रीचेस द अपर पोर्शन ऑफ द नेक, देन इट स्टिल फर्दर असेंड्स अप बाय पासिंग इन बिटवीन द मीडियल वॉल ऑफ द मिडिल ईयर एंड द ऑडिटरी ट्यूब. यहां से जब ये और ऊपर जाएगी, पहले तो ये लेटरल फेरिंजियल वॉल के साथ साथ चढ़ेगी, ठीक है, चूंकि असेंडिंग फेरिंजियल है तो ascend तो करेगी, और pharyngeal है तो pharynx की wall पे ascend करेगी, right? So it ascends along the lateral wall of the pharynx, and of course it will be giving out tonsillar branches. Then when it reaches its ascends high up, you know, at the base of the skull, it continues between the middle ear, medial wall of the middle ear and auditory tube के बीच में ascend करेगी, and वहां जाकर के it will give its meningeal branches, and meningeal branches, you know, it meninges will have to pass through the foramina in the base of the skull. So the meningeal branches from ascending pharyngeal artery will pass through foramen lacerum, jugular foramen, foramen lacerum, jugular foramen, and hypoglossal canal. These are the three foramen from where the meningeal branches of ascending pharyngeal artery will pass through. यानी कि इस आर्टरी का प्राइम पर्पस क्या होगा? असेंडिंग फेरिंजियल आर्टरी नाम है इसका, दैट मींस ये फेरिंग्स को तो सप्लाई करेगी, डन. बट बिकॉज़ इट गिव्स इट्स मेरिंजियल ब्रांचेस व्हिच कंटिन्यूज विद इन द क्रेनियम, दैट मींस इट्स आल्सो इज सप्लाइंग ब्लड टू द मेनिंजेस. नाउ लुक हियर, दिस इज द मीडियल, यू नो, दिस इज द एक्सटर्नल कैरोटिड गिविंग आउट इट्स एंटीरियर ब्रांचेस, ठीक है, सुपीरियर थायरॉइडल लिंगुअल फेशियल, राइट. अब एक ब्रांच निकली मीडियल असेंडिंग फेरिंजियल. नाउ असेंडिंग फेरिंजियल, एज आई टोल्ड यू, इट विल रन डीप, सो इट विल बी इन डीप और पोस्टीरियर रिलेशन टू एक्सटर्नल कैरोटिड, एंड इवन इन पोस्टीरियर रिलेशन टू इंटरनल कैरोटिड. इट विल रन ऑन द साइड वॉल ऑफ फेरिंक्स. दिस कोर्स इज ऑन द साइड ऑफ द फेरिंक्स. सो इन इट्स कोर्स यू सीइंग इट इज गिविंग आउट, सम ब्रांचेस आर गिवन ऑफ टू द वॉल ऑफ द फेरिंक्स, ascend up and will give some branches supply the vertebral muscles, long sculli वगैरह, the anastomose with the branches of ascending cervical and vertebral arteries के साथ anastomosis भी होती रहेगी. Then also it gives a descending branch. A branch descends to the palate. Palate के लिए भी आएगी anastomosis, the ascending palatine branch of facial artery. ठीक है. Ascending palatine branch of the facial artery, which will anastomose with the descending branch of ascending pharyngeal. Ascending palatine तुमको बता चुके हैं इसके बारे में. Facial artery की branch थी ascending palatine and it was running between the stylopharyngeal, styloglossus, and it was climbing up the upper border of superior constrictor muscle to supply the tonsils. So ascending palatine branch will anastomose with the descending branch of the ascending pharyngeal artery. Then this continues further. Now this course is between the middle ear and the auditory tube. ठीक है. And will, because ये middle ear से जा रही है right, तो middle ear के नीचे से pass होगी तो middle ear से भी एक pick दे देगी and it will supply inferior tympanic branch to supply the middle ear. That means ascending pharyngeal artery pharynx को हो गई, tonsil के लिए हो गई, middle ear की हो गई. ठीक है, middle ear में भी supply कर देगी. And ये base of the skull में तीन foramina बता दिए, foramen lacerum, foramen jugular foramen and hypoglossal canal. These are three foramen जहाँ से emissary veins will enter, emissary arteries will enter and supply the meninges. Terminal, some terminal branches जो होती हैं, the meningeal branches pass through foramen lacerum, jugular and hypoglossal canal to supply the meninges, to supply blood to the meninges. Okay. Now look here, this ascending pharyngeal artery, as I told you, this is external carotid, ये lingual artery हो गई, ये हो गई, this is the suprahyoid branch of lingual, याद है? ठीक. This is the facial artery, then this is ascending pharyngeal artery. Now ascending pharyngeal artery ascends up, you can see along the lateral of the pharynx, ascend करेगी. ये occipital है, sorry, ये ascending pharyngeal है, ठीक है, lateral pharynx में जाएंगे और उसके बाद यहाँ cranium के through जो foramina है उनके through now ये अंदर enter करेगी, ये यहाँ पे hypoglossal canal से ये jugular foramen है, ये foramen lacerum है, यहाँ से इसकी branches अंदर जाएंगी cranium को and inside यानी of the cranial vault, inner wall of the cranium. It will run outside the meninges, obviously outside to the dura mater, the epidural space hoti hai, meningeal space, meningeal vessels wahi run karti hai epidural space mein, and it will supply the meninges. Okay, but remember that meningeal branches, yani ke blood supply to the meninges is not only from ascending pharyngeal artery, they are also from vertebral artery which enter to the foramen magnum, and there are also branches from the occipital artery which enter through the mastoid foramen. ठीक है, तो यहाँ पे दिख रहा है meningeal branch of ascending pharyngeal artery, ये यहाँ से enter कर रही है, and posterior meningeal artery from ascending pharyngeal artery, एक ये भी दिखा दी है. तो यानी कि meninges की blood supply जो है वो ascending pharyngeal से तो है ही है, साथ साथ vertebral artery से भी है, occipital artery से भी. ओके, नाउ maxillary, वी हैव reached टू द टर्मिनल ब्रांचेस. द टू टर्मिनल ब्रांचेस आर मैक्सिलरी आर्टरी एंड सुपरफिशियल टेम्पोरल. आउट ऑफ द टू इफ इट्स आस्क्ड व्हिच इज द मेजर टर्मिनल ब्रांच एंड व्हिच इज द माइनर टर्मिनल ब्रांच. So remember that external carotid, the major terminal branch is maxillary artery. It is the bigger branch, terminal branch. Okay. So this is the course of external carotid. Here you're seeing is the maxillary artery and this is superficial temporal, which is a minor branch. This is a major terminal branch, maxillary. Now maxillary artery is given off, it's a terminal branch, one of the terminal branch, it is given out behind the neck of mandible. ठीक है, यहाँ पे ऊपर जो है mandibular fossa होता है, जब condyle of mandible attach होता है, TMJ बना लेता है, temporomandibular joint. So this maxillary artery is given out behind the neck of mandible and it winds medially from the neck of mandible to enter into the infratemporal fossa. Okay. So in this diagram, you are seeing that this is the course of external carotid. In higher up in the face, it passes through the parotid gland, bataya tha, and within the parotid gland, the artery is deep inside. What lies superficial to it is retromandibular vein, and even superficial to that will be facial nerve. Ultimately, this maxillary nerve is given out behind the neck of mandible, and one which continues straight above is superficial temporal artery. Okay, now you're seeing this is the outline, the dotted line. Can you see this dotted line is the neck of mandible, the angle of mandible, ramus of mandible. This is the neck and this is the condyle of mandible. So at the level of the neck of mandible, this is external carotid artery, which is giving its major terminal branch, the maxillary artery, which runs behind the neck of mandible and under the auriculotemporal nerve, along with auriculotemporal nerve. Now, auriculotemporal nerve is the branch of V3 division of trigeminal, that is mandibular nerve ki branch. So now this is the course of mandible maxillary artery. Maxillary artery, I have been telling you that maxillary artery is divided into three parts by lateral pterygoid. Upar ek foramen hai jisko kehte hain foramen ovale, और उसी के पीछे एक फोरामेन है, फोरामेन स्पाइनोसम, एंड फोरामेन स्पाइनोसम से एडजेसेंट होता है स्पाइन ऑफ स्पिनोइड. सो फ्रॉम स्पाइन ऑफ स्पिनोइड देयर इज अ लिगामेंट, राइट? दिस इज अ थिकनिंग ऑफ डी फाशिया, यू नो द स्पाइन ऑफ स्पिनोइड, स्पिनोमैंडिबुलर लिगामेंट. स्पिनोमैंडिबुलर एक्चुअली इट्स अ डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट ब्रेनकियल आर्च. सो स्पिनोमैंडिबुलर लिगामेंट रीचेस डाउन and attaches to the lingula of the mandibular foramen. By the way, hum dheere dheere cheeze samajh mein aa jayengi jab book khologe padhoge. So which nerve emerges out from foramen ovale is mandibular nerve, which we call as V3 division of trigeminal. From there you find is auriculotemporal nerve is given out, and this auriculotemporal nerve also carries parasympathetic fibers to the parotid gland, right? It's going like this. So maxillary artery, when it reaches behind, you know, its first part of the maxillary artery, you find there's this branch called middle meningeal artery, which passes between the loop of the auriculotemporal nerve in essence, and through the foramen spinosum it reaches inside the skull. And don't forget that meningeal artery, naam hai iska middle meningeal artery, so obviously meningeal ब्लड सप्लाई टू मेनिंजेस में तुमको जो बताई थी आर्टरीज, उसमें यू कैन इंक्लूड दैट मैक्सिलरी थ्रू इट्स मिडिल मेनिंजियल आर्टरी आल्सो सप्लाइज द मेनिंजेस. देन दिस मैंडिबुलर नर्व डिवाइड्स एंटरली इनटू लिंगुअल नर्व व्हिच सप्लाइज द टंग एंड इंफीरियर एल्वियोलर नर्व व्हिच पासेस थ्रू द मैंडिबुलर फोरामेन टू एंटर द मैंडिबल एंड सप्लाइज द लोअर टीथ ऑल ऑफ देम. Right, and it emerges as mental nerve. Okay, then you are seeing here that maxillary artery is the larger terminal branch of external carotid artery and runs below the auriculotemporal nerve behind the neck of mandible. Okay. Now this. Actually, you know, हम इसमें बहुत डिटेल में इसलिए भी नहीं टाइम खराब कर रहे हैं, बिकॉज देयर विल बी अ सेपरेट लेक्चर ऑन मैक्सिलरी आर्टरी एंड मैक्सिलरी नर्व. ठीक है, तो मैक्सिलरी आर्टरी विल बी टॉट अगेन टू यू इन डिटेल, लेकिन फिर भी चूंकि बात आई है, क्योंकि ये लार्जर टर्मिनल ब्रांच एक्सटर्नल कैरोटिड की. सो एज आई वॉज टेलिंग इन इट्स कोर्स इट राइट, यू नो, ये नेक ऑफ मैंडिबल है एंड इट हैज दिस कोर्स रनिंग मीडियली, राइट? इट गोज मीडियली forwards and slightly upwards, right, to reach towards the nose deep inside. So its course will be like this, and you know this because of this lower head of lateral pterygoid which is crossing. Remember, it's not the upper head, it's the lower head of lateral pterygoid which divides this artery into three parts, first, second and third part. सो दे ब्रांचेस गिवन आउट ऑफ फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट ब्रांच, उसमें क्या है डीप ऑरिकुलर ब्रांचेस हैं, एंटीरियर टिम्पैनिक आर्टरी है, देन योर मिडिल मेनिंजियल आर्टरी, असेंडिंग मेनिंजियल आर्टरी एंड द इंफीरियर एल्वियोलर आर्टरी फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट ब्रांच. सेकेंड से क्या है मैसेट्रिक ब्रांचेस हैं टू सप्लाई द मैसेटर मसल्स लाइक यू नो मिडिल डेरिवेट को भी. देन देर आर बक्कल आर्टरीज एंड नर्व, देन देर आर डीप टेम्पोरल टेम्पोरालिस के लिए भी हैं एंड टेरिगॉइड्स के लिए भी हैं, तो टेरिगॉइड ब्रांचेस हो. देन अल्टीमेटली द थर्ड पोर्शन, द थर्ड इज डीप इनसाइड एंड थर्ड पोर्शन जो है दैट रीचेज द टेरिगोपैलेटाइन फोसा, और वहां पे इट विल गिव आर्टरी टू द टेरिगॉइड कैनाल. ठीक है, दिस इज फेरिंजियल आर्टरी एंड आर्टरी टू द टेरिगॉइड कैनाल. And there it also gives infraorbital artery which runs through the orbit. Then posterior superior alveolar artery, this supplies the molar, upper molar teeth. And this greater palatine artery you're seeing, this greater palatine artery descends down and reaches the hard palate to supply the hard palate, greater palatine artery. And ultimately, this artery perforates the medial wall of the pterygopalatine fossa to enter into the nose to supply the lateral wall of the nose. This sphelopalatine artery, jo hai, as well as the nasal septum, this is the terminal part. So, if it's asked, like, you know, what is the terminal branch of maxillary artery? The answer will be sphenopalatine artery. You are seeing this is the term, you know, external carotid. Continuation is superficial temporal, minor branch, major is maxillary artery. So there you seeing this is the zygomatic arch which has been cut to expose the continuation of maxillary artery. Now this area is called infratemporal fossa. So the course of the maxillary artery from behind the ramus of mandible will be cut. So it runs, and this is superior constrictor muscle. So it runs along the upper border of the superior constrictor and in the infratemporal fossa. And now you see a pterygomaxillary fissure. You have pterygoid process, this is maxilla, so this is pterygomaxillary fissure. From there it reaches inside, or yonder ki taraf ek fossa dikh raha hai, deep inside, and this is called pterygopalatine fossa. So it reaches into the pterygopalatine fossa, and then you know you can see is a fissure there, and this is opening into the orbits, and this is called infraorbital fissure. Through this infraorbital fissure, it continues as infraorbital artery. Now this infraorbital artery will emerge on the face through this infraorbital foramen. Okay, look here. External carotid hai, neck of mandible ke piche isne maxillary artery di, crosses the neck of mandible, reaches down, and phir andar jaake ye apni sari branches degi, mesenteric, meningeal branches, accessory meningeal, and the inferior alveolar. Inferior alveolar you see is continuing and mandible on its medial surface as a foramen, the mandibular foramen. So inferior alveolar artery will run along the mandibular inferior alveolar nerve into this mandibular canal and will emerge out to the mental foramen on the chin, right? So this is called mental artery. ठीक है, और सब mental artery is a branch of, rather it is the largest branch of facial artery. Then the further course here is in the infratemporal fossa, it also gives a buccal branch, right? And it also gives posterior superior alveolar artery. Posterior superior alveolar artery, they have not shown, they will that supplies the blood to the molar, upper molars. And inferior alveolar artery will supply blood to all the lower teeth. Then this is the orbital portion. This is infraorbital nerve which emerges out through the infraorbital foramen and supplies the front skin of the front of face. Okay, now this is continuation of superficial temporal where you see a transverse facial artery is given. Now this transverse facial artery courses through the parotid gland. And ultimately the superficial temporal divides into its anterior and posterior divisions in the temple. सो दिस इज मैक्सिलरी आर्टरी और बाकी सारी डिटेल में दिखाई जाएंगी, सिर्फ ये दिखा देते हैं इन दिस टेरिकोपेलेटाइन फोसा यू कैन सी दिस दिस वॉज टेरिको मैक्सिलरी फिशर नाउ दिस इज टेरिकोपेलेटाइन फोसा वहां पे क्या है दिस मैक्सिलरी आर्टरी वॉज गिवन इट्स पोस्टीरियर क्या कहते हैं इसको sends down perforates to the greater palatine fossa and runs on the under surface of the hard palate yani ki palate ki oral cavity ki taraf you know from the oral side it supplies the hard palate then it gives this branch called this is the posterior superior alveolar artery theek hai this is posterior superior alveolar artery it supplies the upper teeth especially molars and premolars then in this infraorbital canal it gives this anterior inferior alveolar remember anterior superior alveolar will supply blood to the incisors and canine upper incisor and canine ki blood supply anterior superior alveolar although yahan pe ek middle superior alveolar bhi hoti hai which is supply the canine and this premolar first premolar so in short you can say that all the blood to the upper teeth they are supplied by branches from the posterior superior alveolar middle superior alveolar anterior superior alveolar they are all branches from the maxillary artery although posterior superior alveolar is given out from before it enters the orbit yani ki derivalent fossa se nikal rahi hai baki orbit ke andar se nikalti and ultimately this infraorbital nerve continuation of this maxillary on the face it passes out through this infraorbital foramen to supply the skin on the face now one of the major branches I told you from the first part of maxillary artery this is the first part of maxillary artery it further continues and divides into inferior alveolar and the major continuation of the maxillary artery now the first part this portion will run over the lateral pterygoid muscle but this I'm talking here is the first part you can say first part se kya nikalegi deep auricular arteries niklengi theek anterior tympanic artery niklegi inferior tympanic hum bata chuke hain theek hai now this is anterior tympanic inferior tympanic kiski thi post ascending pharyngeal ki branch thi now anterior tympanic is from first part of meningeal artery then this will give a branch called middle meningeal artery and another branch is this is as an accessory pharyngeal theek hai now look here this is middle meningeal artery it passes this is mandibular nerve and the branch given out from mandibular nerve is auricular temporal it is a loop through this loop this middle meningeal artery ascends up and through a foramen there called sphenoid foramen you know sphenoidal foramen usse it will enter into the skull and will supply the meninges especially on the inner side of the temple then this is accessory pharyngeal artery it will pass along to the main trunk of mandibular nerve and the main trunk of mandibular emerges through the foramen ovale so MALE is the mnemonic MALE so mandibular nerve and this is a branch from you know accessory meningeal artery theek hai and lesser petrosal nerve ne for emissary vein so MALE is the mnemonic for the structures coming out through the passing through the foramen ovale so one of the structures is accessory meningeal artery this is the maxillary artery in the infratemporal fossa this is middle meningeal artery through the foramen spinosum it enters the skull and it divides into posterior and anterior divisions which supply the skull on the inner side thick or this remember was this portion was called pterion right jo maine jab hum introductory class le rahe the tab bataya tha this point where the four bones meet which is h shaped suture is called pterion right ये ग्रेटर विंग ऑफ स्फिनॉइड है ये टेम्पोरल है ये पराइटल है ये फ्रंटल है ऑल फोर बोन्स मीट हियर दिस कॉल्ड टेरियन एंड यहां पे मैंने बताया था कि सुपरफिशियल टेम्पोरल आर्टरी भी पास होती है मिडिल मेनिंजियल आर्टरी भी पास होती है एंटी डिविजन ऑफ मिडिल मेनिंजियल वेन भी पास होती है एंड ब्रेन का कौन सा एरिया होता है यहाँ पे सिल्वियन पॉइंट राइट यहाँ पे स्टेम ऑफ लिटिल सल्कस डिवाइड होता है. सो दिस पॉइंट यहाँ पे दिखा रहे हैं, सुसाइड करने पे गन शॉट कर लेते हैं. दिस इज अ लॉट ऑफ वाइटल स्ट्रक्चर्स एंड रिमेंबर व्हाट पासेस हियर इज द फ्रंटल ब्रांच ऑफ द एंटीरियर ब्रांच ऑफ मिडिल मेनिंजियल आर्टरी. ये डायग्राम का स्क्रीनशॉट ले सकते हो, ये डिटेल में तुम्हें बाद में कराया जाएगा, मैं उसमें और डिटेल नहीं कराऊंगा. दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द ब्रांचेस ऑफ मैक्सिलरी आर्टरी. ठीक, इंफीरियर एलिवेलर की से क्या क्या ब्रांचेस हैं यहाँ पर हैं, एंड ये सुपीरियर एलिवेलर से क्या क्या ब्रांचेस हैं वो यहाँ पर है. आई मीन सुपीरियर एलिवेलर कह रहे हैं, सॉरी द कंटिन्यूशन ऑफ मैक्सिलरी आर्टरी से जो जो ब्रांचेस हैं वो यहाँ पर है. ठीक, एंड एक बार फिर कोई बता देगा जल्दी, टर्मिनल ब्रांच ऑफ मैक्सिलरी आर्टरीज, सॉरी द मैक्सिलरी आर्टरी टर्मिनेट्स एज विच आर्टरी. ये है कोर्स मैक्सिलरी आर्टरी का. सो इट टर्मिनेट्स एज स्पिनो पैलेटाइन, एंड स्पिनो पैलेटाइन अंदर जाके नोज में इट विल गिव पोस्टीरियर सेप्टल एंड पोस्टीरियर लेटरल नेजल, यानी इट सप्लाईज ब्लड टू द नेजल सेप्टम एज वेल एज द लेटरल वॉल ऑफ द नोज. ठीक है, एक ब्रांच बताई थी मैंने, थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ द मैक्सिलरी से विच वॉज डिसेंडिंग डाउन, एंड दैट वॉज डिसेंडिंग डाउन एंड रीचिंग ऑन टू द अंडर सर्फेस ऑफ द सॉफ्ट पैलेट, दैट मीन्स द रूफ ऑफ द ओरल कैविटी, एंड दिस इज ग्रेटर पैलेटाइन आर्टरी एंड ग्रेटर पैलेटाइन नर्व. तो ग्रेटर जहां पे फोरामेन होते हैं, ग्रेटर पैलेटाइन फोरामेन, राइट. तो ग्रेटर पैलेटाइन आर्टरी रन्स ऑन द अंडर सर्फेस ऑफ द हार्ट पैलेट, और यू कैन सी इन द रूफ ऑफ द ओरल कैविटी की जो ब्लड सप्लाई है वो है ग्रेटर पैलेटाइन आर्टरी से, एंड दिस इज अ ब्रांच ऑफ मैक्सिलरी आर्टरी. एक बात और हमने पिछले लेक्चर में बताई थी, बिकॉज दिस इज मैक्सिलरी आर्टरी, इट्स कोर्स विल बी रनिंग इन रिलेशन टू द लेटल टेरिगॉइड, एंड लेटल टेरिगॉइड के बारे में आई हैव बीन टेलिंग यू दैट इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड द पेरिफेरल हार्ट, एंड द रीजन वाई इट वॉज कॉल्ड पेरिफेरल हार्ट बिकॉज देर वॉज दिस टेरिगॉइड वेनस प्लेक्सस एम्बेडेड इन एंड अराउंड दिस लिटिल टेरिगॉइड मसल, दैट्स वाई, एंड दिस वॉज द मसल विच कॉजेज ओपनिंग ऑफ द जॉ. So that was, I told you that the, because of continuous collection of carbon dioxide or deoxygenated blood, there is an impulse for hyperventilation and which causes yawning or the squeezing of blood from the pterygoid venous plexus. So remember, pterygoid venous plexus surrounds, you can see, it surrounds the maxillary artery. Okay. Last branch is the superficial temporal artery, which is the minor continuation of maxillary artery or minor terminal branch of the maxillary artery. Maxillary artery, maxillary, sorry, this is the external carotid, maxillary is this. This is the superficial temporal. Superficial temporal, jab ye artery ascend karegi, obviously, upar ja karke, to temple pe jayegi. But remember, because it's superficial, so it will supply, it will not reach within the skull, right? So it will supply the scalp, mainly on the scalp, and you know that pinna, and it will supply the muscles on the scalp. But before it goes above, it gives its branch through the parotid gland to supply the face, and this is called transverse facial artery. This artery runs along the, koi batayega, this artery runs along the parotid duct. ठीक है, ट्रांसवर्स फेशियल आर्टरी. ये देखो, दिस इज सुपरफिशियल टेम्पोरल आर्टरी, और ये निकल जाएगी पैरोटिड को, पैरोटिड ग्लैंड क्रॉस करके ऊपर. ठीक, नाउ हियर यू सीइंग इज दिस एक्सटर्नल कैरोटिड आर्टरी, ये निकली यहां से, इसमें मैक्सिलरी आर्टरी. ठीक है, मैक्सिलरी आर्टरी की इंफीरियर एलिवेलर आर्टरी होती है, वो मेंटल आर्टरी कहलाती है. ठीक, और मैंने बताया था फेशियल आर्टरी की ब्रांच होती है सबमेंटल आर्टरी, व्हिच इज द लार्जेस्ट ब्रांच ऑफ फेशियल आर्टरी. नाउ लुक हियर, दिस इज सुपरफिशियल टेम्पोरल आर्टरी, एंड इट इज गिवन आउट दिस ट्रांसवर्स फेशियल आर्टरी व्हिच रन्स बिटवीन द पैरोटिड डक्ट एंड द जाइगोमेटिक आर्च. यू कैन सी आई हैव ड्रॉन इट हियर दैट द साइड ऑफ द स्कल यू फाइंड दिस इज जाइगोमेटिक बोन, एंड हियर यू हैव इट अ टेम्पोरल बोन. तो जाइगोमेट्रिक को टेम्पोरल सूचर होता है यहाँ पे. सो दिस इज अ आर्क लाइक हियर, तो दैट्स कॉल्ड जाइगोमेटिक आर्क. ठीक, तो एंड दिस एंटीरियर पॉइंट ऑफ द जाइगोमेटिक आर्च इज कॉल्ड जाइगोमा. ठीक है, और प्री ऑरिकुलर पॉइंट भी कहते हैं यहाँ पे. सो दिस सुपरफिशियल टेम्पोरल आर्टरी क्रॉसेस दिस जाइगोमेटिक आर्च एंड एसेंड्स फर्दर ऑन द टेम्पल. बट एट द लेवल ऑफ दिस जाइगोमेटिक आर्च इट गिव्स इट्स ट्रांसवर्स फेशियल आर्टरी. याद रखना, ट्रांसवर्स फेशियल आर्टरी रन्स बिटवीन द पैरोटिड डक्ट along with the parotid duct and zygomatic arch has a similar course. Now this artery, superficial temporal artery, as its ascends anterior to the ear, right? So I told you this also is called anesthetist's artery. Another artery is facial artery. Both of them are easily palpable. You can keep palpating the facial artery here at the angle of the, I mean, anterior to the angle of mandible. Is easily palpable, and even this superficial temporal, how is it palpable? Remember that on the ear you have a tragus, right? It's a cartilaginous tip. So anterior to the tragus is the zygomatic arch. So 5 centimeters above to the zygomatic arch, or the root of the zygomatic arch, is called zygoma or preauricular point. So 5 centimeters above to the preauricular point or the zygomatic arch, you keep your finger and you can palpate for the pulsations of superficial temporal artery. Okay? That's the site for palpation of, and you know, the anesthetist norm general, I mean, they have their table sitting on, you know, this position is to the head end of the OT table. So normally they can easily palpate superficial temporal, or to they can take the pulsations from the pulse rate from the superficial temporal or the facial artery. Then further course, it divides into anterior and posterior divisions, right? Superficial temporal. And it also gives a middle temporal. Yaad rakhna, middle temporal branch jo hoti hai, to superficial ho gayi dono, anterior and posterior divisions. Middle temporal, yahan pe ek muscle hoti, that's called temporalis, right? So the middle temporal will be deep artery. Now it will run on the under surface of temporalis. Theek hai? So middle temporal runs deep to the temporalis muscle. Now the anterior division of the superficial temporal will run further here on the scalp, and it will anastomose with the branches of supratrochlear and supraorbital arteries on the scalp. And you know that that is another site for anastomosis between internal carotid and external carotid arteries. So one is the site is the scalp, and anterior to the ear on the scalp, and other is on the root of the nose, medial canthus of the eye. These are the two sites where there are anastomosis between internal and external carotid arteries. Okay, superficial temporal ka ye ja raha hai course. Theek hai, to yahan pe ye cheez dikhaiye, this muscle here which covers the temple is called temporalis, one of the muscle of mastication, which is covered by temporal fascia. So because it's superficial artery, right? Superficial temporal naam is, but I told you it gives a middle temporal branch which will run on the under surface of temporalis, this branch. And there are branch, temporal branches, muscular branches from the maxillary artery as well. So all of them, these are branches of the middle meningeal in the cranial. So ye to cranial cavity mein andar chali jati hai, but remember there are muscular branches, yani ki temporalis ki blood supply maxillary or superficial temporal ki middle temporal artery के through है, ठीक? देखो ये terminal branch होगी maxillary, external carotid. Now this is superficial temporal, anteriorly along the zygomatic arch, along the parotid duct, transverse facial artery दी, ऊपर चढ़े थोड़ा और फिर zygomatic branch दी to supply the skin on the face along the zygomatic bone. Then it will give a middle temporal branch. This will be a deep branch. It will supply temporalis muscle on its inner surface. Then it will have an anterior auricular branch, will supply the muscles on the front of ear. Then it will give a frontal branch, which will anastomose with the branches from supratrochlear or parietal on the scalp. And it will give a parietal branch, which will reach towards the vertex of the head. ठीक है, scalp में चली जाएगी. Here you are seeing this is superficial temporal running up anterior to the ear, posterior auricular from behind the ear, occipital in the back. So these are the three branches from the external carotid on the scalp, and supratrochlear, supraorbital, these are the branches from the ophthalmic artery. So anastomosis between internal external carotid arteries also happens at the on the scalp and through the ear. Now let me ask you, which is the longest branch of ophthalmic artery? क्योंकि ये तो इंटरनल कैरोटिड की ब्रांच है, तो याद रखना दैट सुप्रो ऑर्बिटल नर्व एज वेल एज सुप्रो ऑर्बिटल आर्टरी ये यहाँ तक आएगी, ऊपर आके स्कैल्प में एनास्टोमोस करेगी। एंड इसकी भी स्क्रीनशॉट ले लेना क्योंकि ये पूरा 5 नंबर का क्वेश्चन आता है अबाउट द सेंसरी एंड मोटर नर्व सप्लाई ऑफ द स्कैल्प एज वेल एज द ब्लड सप्लाई ऑफ स्कैल्प। ठीक है, सो यू आर डन नाउ। आज का टॉपिक हो गया है, बहुत लेंथी टॉपिक था, सारी आर्टरीज बहुत डिटेल में सब में क्वेश्चंस आते हैं, सब में एमसीक्यूज आते हैं। मेक श्योर ये आज ही पूरी रीडिंग लगा लेना किताब में से, ठीक है? ओके, दो तीन क्वेश्चंस हैं, इसको सॉल्व कर लेते हैं एमसीक्यूज, लेट्स सी आंसर कौन सही दे रहा है इसका। आराम से रीड कर लो इसको। 57-year-old woman was seen by her obstetrician and gynecologist complaining of bearing down, feeling in the pelvis. Bearing down in feeling in the perineum का मतलब हुआ उसको ऐसा लगता है कि there is something coming out on the out in the perineal surface. And also she complains of low back ache. So on vaginal examination the external os of the cervix was found to be located just within the vaginal orifice, yani ki pp examination pe jaise hi you know if you examine karenge you will find that the cervix with its external os has reached to the margins of vaginal orifice. Diagnosis banayi gayi, kya bani diagnosis? Of uterine prolapse, yani uterus niche aa gaya hai. And the following statements regarding uterine prolapse are correct except which? Now this is a question which all has been taught to you about the pelvis, uterus and vagina se related hai, muscles of the pelvis se related hai, blood vessels and nerve supply of the pelvis se related hai. So think about an answer. Which statement, the following statements regarding uterine prolapse are correct? Sab kuch sahi hai except one statement. Which is the wrong statement? सिमरन सी, अनुज कुमार सी। मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट सपोर्ट टू द यूट्रस इज द टोन ऑफ द लिवेटर एनआई मसल। ये बात सही है कि नहीं? डैमेज टू द लिवेटर एनआई एंड सर्वाइकल लिगमेंट्स ड्यूरिंग चाइल्ड बर्थ कैन बी रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर द प्रोलैप्स ऑफ द यूट्रस। यूट्रस में पढ़ाया गया है देयर आर लॉट्स ऑफ लिगामेंट्स इन सपोर्ट ऑफ द यूट्रस व्हिच मेंटेन द पोजीशन इन सीटू ऑफ द यूट्रस। देन प्रोलैप्स कॉमनली रिवील्स इटसेल्फ बिफोर मेनोपॉज। ये बात सही है कि नहीं? प्रोलैप्स ऑफ द यूट्रस इज ऑलवेज अकंपेनड बाय सम प्रोलैप्स ऑफ द वजाइना। जब यूट्रस यानी एक्सटर्नल ऑस वजाइनल ओरिफाइस पे आ गया है तो दैट मींस Vagina is obviously pushed down, right? तो इसमें आंसर जो है वो ए बी सी डी में कौन सा आंसर, विच स्टेटमेंट इज रॉन्ग? फॉलोइंग प्रोलैप्स इज करेक्ट एक्सेप्ट विच, विच इज द रॉन्ग स्टेटमेंट? आंसर इज सी। एक बहुत सिंपल सी बात है कि जो लिवेटर एनाई मसल है दैट्स अ मेन सपोर्ट ऑफ द यूट्रस, ठीक है? सो इट्स जनरली रिवील्स जो पोस्ट मेनोपॉजल, तुमने यहां पे अगर क्वेश्चन पे ध्यान दिया होता एज कितनी लिखी है, 57 लिखा हुआ है, तो 57 ऑब्वियसली कम्स इन द मेनोपॉजल एज, आई मीन पोस्ट मेनोपॉजल, ठीक है? सो द आंसर इज सी। तो इस तरह से इसीलिए कहते हैं क्वेश्चन में अगर क्लिनिकल क्वेश्चन होता है उसमें एज का बहुत बड़ा क्लू हो रहता है, तो हर चीज पे ध्यान देना चाहिए। तो प्रोलैप्स तो है ये, डायग्नोसिस तो क्वेश्चन में ही बना दिए, तो अब इससे पता चल गया कि जब 57 की बात हो रही है तो प्रोलैप्स कॉमनली रिवील्स इटसेल्फ बिफोर मेनोपॉज इज द रॉन्ग आंसर। इट्स आंसर इन दिस बट इट्स द रॉन्ग स्टेटमेंट। सो एक्सप्लेनेशन क्या हो गया, प्रोलैप्स द यूट्रस मोस्ट ऑफन रिवील्स इटसेल्फ आफ्टर मेनोपॉज व्हेन द पेल्विक फाशिया टेंड्स टू एट्रोफी। ओके, आंसर सी हो गया। ये बता दो जल्दी से, कोस्टल मार्जिन, राइट? कोस्टल मार्जिन जैसे कहते हैं ना जो रिब केज का लोअर मार्जिन होता है, कार्टिलेजिनस होता है, तो कोस्टल मार्जिन रीचेस इट्स लोएस्ट लेवल इन द मिड एक्सिलरी लाइन। Here, the margin is formed by which costal cartilage? कौन बताएगा सही आंसर? कोई और? हाँ, इसका आंसर बताओ। सन्नी, अभिषेक, अनामिका। बहुत बार क्लास में बताया है ये, दैट मिड एक्सिलरी लाइन में द लोएस्ट लाइंग रिब इज द 10th रिब। ठीक है, वही क्वेश्चन है। इन द मिड एक्सिलरी लाइन द लोएस्ट लाइंग रिब इज द 10th रिब। सो द कोस्टल मार्जिन रीचेज इट्स लोएस्ट लेवल इन द मिड एक्सिलरी लाइन इज एट द लेवल ऑफ 10th रिब। हाँ भाई, इसको बताओ। ऑल कैन एक्ट एज एंटी ग्रेविटी मसल्स एक्सेप्ट, यानी कौन सी मसल एंटी ग्रेविटी मसल नहीं है? जल्दी से बताओ। ग्लूटियस मैक्सिमस इज अ पावरफुल एक्सटेंसर ऑफ हिप जॉइंट, यू नो दैट। कैस्ट्रो सोलियस इज अ पावरफुल एक्सटेंसर ऑफ एंकल जॉइंट। क्वाड्रिसेप फिमोरिस इज अ पावरफुल एक्सटेंसर ऑफ नी जॉइंट। एंड ऑल दीज जॉइंट्स नीड टू बी एक्सटेंडेड व्हेन यू आर ट्राइंग टू स्टैंड अप फ्रॉम अ स्क्वाटिंग पोजीशन। दैट मींस ऑल द थ्री मसल्स ए बी एंड डी आर एंटी ग्रेविटी। पॉपलीटियस एक्चुअली रोटेट्स योर फीमर लेटरली व्हेन योर फुट इज ऑन द ग्राउंड, बट व्हेन योर फुट इज ऑफ द ग्राउंड पॉपलीटियस रोटेट्स टिबिया मीडियली। ठीक है, सो पॉपलीटियस हैज नॉट इनफ रोल इन एक्टिंग एज एन एंटी ग्रेविटी मसल। क्लियर? यू गॉट द आंसर? सो यू आर डन विद दिस टॉपिक अबाउट ऑल द मेजर ऑल द ब्रांचेस, फ्रॉम एक्सटर्नल कैरोटिड इवन द कॉमन कैरोटिड, इट्स ऑल डन।